Cork's Hit Music Station, Red FM. Hey-o, good morning. Welcome to Red Breakfast. It's Ray Foley here. Laura O'Mahony's over there.
Hi there.
Do you want to do this? Is she, I don't know if she even picked up the phone. I don't know if she'd going to pick up the phone.
Oh, my God. Did she answer? Is she there? Absolutely. Are you there?
Sinead Quinlan. Hello. Hello. Good morning.
She's there.
It's Sinead Quinlan. She answered the phone.
Yay.
She answered the phone.
She did it.
Sinead Quinlan is on the line, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh,
it's our pleasure to find you.
I'm so stressed to actually be awake. I set like 5 alarms. I'm like, oh my God. this is an insane time of the morning for a comedian to be awake. Like,
oh, it's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. Laura's on the show every morning. Laura's a comedian as well, of course. She doesn't actually wake up. This is all in her sleep. This is.
I don't wake up till about 3 o'clock. You know yourself, Sinead.
Yeah, exactly.
How are you?
I'm great, guys. How are you?
Yeah, we're pretty good, actually. Just to fill people in, we tried to get you before and you slept it out. So that's why Sinead has been up all night waiting for the second to call. But we don't mind.
Coffee.
We don't mind. We're grand. So come here. 2020 was a crap year for everyone else on the planet except for Dua Lipa and you.
I know, our stories are very similar as well, like, so, me and Dua.
You exploded on the scene in 2020. You were on the Den for their glorious return at the end of last year. What's it like meeting Ziggy? I mean, they say never meet your heroes. What was that like?
Oh, stop. Like, to be honest, I spent the entire time on the Den just trying not to be fangirling, like, you know, it was just such a crazy experience. Like, I'd met Ray quite a few times, so Ray was nearly norm at this point. So I was like, oh, how are you, Remy, old flower? But the three lads, Dustin, Zig and Zag, my God, like, they're just absolute legends. Like, they're icons, do you know what I mean? Absolute icons to everybody. So it was crazy working with them. But they're so sound. And they made me feel so welcome, like, I was proper part of the family. So it was lovely.
How do they work? Like, in terms of coming up with ideas, like, would they be, I suppose, bosses to you? Would they tell you what they wanted to do, or would they give you free rein to do some of your own stuff? What was the dynamic like?
So, like, there was kind of teams every week. I think one of my favourite weeks, well, I loved them all, to be honest, but one of my favourites is definitely, like, International Francis Brennan Day. that was hilarious. So, like, they'd say, like, that's the team. But it was very much, like, just do what you want. Do you know what I mean? Like, I knew I was going to be in a different place. So, obviously, for anyone who didn't watch it, I was a roving reporter. Yeah. So I was in a different, like, town every week. So I knew that, so they'd have that, right? But other than that, it was pretty much, like, do what you want. Do you know what I mean? Just try not to offend people. That was it.
Yeah, that's the gig, really, Sinead. We've all been doing that for our careers. Do you know, Laura, every Monday morning, Laura was like a mammy about you. She was like, did you see our Sinead last night? She was delighted for you.
She's from Cork. She's going to be huge. I keep texting Sinead telling her she's going to be huge.
I know, yeah. I was saying to Laura, like, yeah, I should probably lay off the takeaways, right? Like, we'll be big enough.
Yeah, that's the lockdown pounds, Sinead. That's what that is.
Yeah.
Tell us about the TV show. You're on telly tonight with your own show now.
Yeah, which is crazy. So it's called Seriously Sinead, which is a phrase my parents would have said many a time over the year. So, what's it about? It's kind of about me, basically, but it's like an exaggerated version of me. So it's like stand-up careers taking off, and then, you know, boom, global pandemic. So there's like 4 kind of main themes to it. So it's like, where can I get stand-up back in my life, my love life, social awkwardness, which I'm very good at. Do you know what I mean? Like, you can show me on the Den on live TV, like, no bother at all. But in a one-to-one situation, I just can't cope at all.
Gotcha.
And then facing my fears as well is the last one. But, it's fun. It's, like, lighthearted, a bit crazy. Like, there's talking birds. It's not Dustin this time. there's me. Oh, my dad's in it, actually, as well. And he will change the way you eat biscuits forever. Like,
oh, okay.
It's, yeah, honestly, I don't think there's a wrong way to eat biscuits, like, but it'll definitely improve your technique.
Okay, worth checking out. So what time are you on it? It's tonight on RT2?
RT2 at 10:20.
Okay, set your DVR or stay up. 10:20, it's very late for, you know, Laura would be glued to it.
She'll, oh, I know. That's like, that's I like watched afternoon it a couple of times. For me.
Laura will be live tweeting us tonight.
Oh, my God.
You're comedy mom. You're a surrogate comedy mama.
I know. Me and Laura are good friends. Like, she's a comedy scene.
Oh, she's so proud of you.
Up, especially Cork scene. Yeah, we're good friends.
I remember when I used to be the young one, and now I'm a comedy mom.
Comedy mom.
Nice one, Ray.
She's disgusted. Right, Sinead Quinn, tonight, telly, 20 past 10, RTE2 television, worth checking out. It's
I'm going all out, like, I'm going to take a shower and all, like, you know, special occasion, big
making a big deal of it. right, go on, listen, thanks for joining us, thanks for staying up all night, you can go and take a nap now,
and catch the show tonight. Thanks, guys.
Sinead Quinn, and thanks a million, have a good day, stay safe.
Bye, see ya.
Love to talk to you. Bye. Breakfast on